Welcome back to another video. Today we are going to look at date pickers in Microsoft Word. You may have seen these on the inbuilt cover pages. Press the drop down to open the calendar, scroll to a specific year and month, and press a day to apply the text. Probably the best part though, being able to apply the current date to a document with the click of a button. Date pickers are great for cover pages. Also good for filling out repetitive forms. In this video, we will cover how to add a date picker to your document. We will also look at date picker properties and styling. Date picker content controls are found in the developer ribbon, but you may be wondering, where is this magical developer ribbon? Usually hidden, we will need to enable it in the options. Right-click on a ribbon heading and press Customize the ribbon. In the right-hand box, tick Developer and press OK. The developer ribbon will now be visible. In the control section of the ribbon, we have a range of control boxes. We have check boxes, combo boxes, drop-down lists, and the date picker. These control boxes are actually very useful for streamlining documents and forms. Automation also helps to reduce manual entry errors. Click on the date picker icon to add a date picker control box to your document. The font style of the picker will match the style of the surrounding text, but it can be styled differently like any other text. Color, font, font size can all be changed. You can even apply presets from the styles bar. Make sure to select a date before making changes to the style. Otherwise, formatting will be lost when a date is first selected. Alternatively, formatting can be applied when setting up the properties. After adding the picker to the document, we will want to customize its look and operation. After selecting the date picker, we can hit Properties in the developer ribbon. This window will allow us to change the control box title, text that appears just above the control box. You can change the outline color for the control box. We previously mentioned the issues about font style resetting. You can use this tick box to apply a specific font style on user input. This is a good one. By ticking this box, when the user selects a date, the control box will disappear. It becomes normal text. We can change the date formatting, even using our own custom format. On the screen is a cheat sheet for the date formatting rules. To give you an example, DD space MMMM space YYYY provides the output 08 October 2023, a fairly typical format used for business documents. If you prefer to use presets, changing the date location will provide different formatting options based on your local standards. I believe the best approach with date pickers and control boxes in general is to experiment and use them whenever possible. Understanding what they can do and where they work best will help you design efficient forms and documents. And more importantly, impress work colleagues with fancy automated templates. Thanks for watching. See you next time.